We're ready. Ooh, look. And I was smart enough to stay here for a second to make sure that I didn't cut off the top of your head. Because guess what? I was cutting off the top of your head.
Hi. Hi. Welcome to Come Knit With Us, episode 50.
5-0. Oh. Finally an episode older than me. High five.
Look,
that was very smart. We hurt each other when we hit.
She hurts me real bad.
Yeah, because I'm the big tough one.
Yeah.
Hi, Kathy Canuel.
Hi,
legendary crafting icon.
We're lucky to have her in our private rooms today because she had a trunk show here at Tempe Yarn and Fiber.
Local
and science,
spectacular.
And beauty, and tech support, and travel.
And travel? Well, that's right, because we have a travel commentator now.
That's right.
We have a travel reporter.
And she was selling her lovely wares, her stitch markers, her stitch mark necklaces.
Oh, and her earrings.
This is the Mark II.
Mark II. New earrings.
Her earrings.
I'm wearing older earrings of hers.
I'm wearing brand new ones that I just got because they match my eyeshadow. Don't they?
You look lovely. Hi.
Thank you.
By the way, I'm Sam, also known as Kermit Von Frog 12 on Ravelry and YouTube. What?
Oh, never mind. Hang on. I thought, oh my God, I love my phone. It's right here. My butt was holding on to it. Sorry.
Who are you?
I'm Kathy.
Known as Kathy Canuel.
LCI Kathy.
LCI. Like
and Kathy Canuel on Instagram.
That's right.
And on the YouTubes.
Yeah, that's right. She has a little podcast too.
Mm-hmm. She does?
Yeah.
Go find her. YouTube,
we're
Kathy
huge
Canuel.
Fans.
We are. Total fangirls.
Fangirls.
Are cute.
And I'm Kim.
Also known as
Kimmy Knits or Kimmy Knits. K-I-M-I-K-N-I-T-S. On Ravelry, Instagram, Twitter,
not YouTube, like knits,
everywhere.
Like for lice, like knits.
Not like
knits. No, not knits. Not knit lice. No.
No.
God.
No.
Like, we escaped that.
Yeah.
Good.
Did you?
Good.
Did you ever have to do that?
No.
Me either. And I'm so lucky. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Never in my whole life.
We kind of expected it with daycare.
Yeah, but it
didn't
happen for us.
No, we were very, very lucky.
Yeah.
Very,
same very here. Lucky. Same here.
So now that we've talked about lice and Kathy's Dray Great Trunk Show.
Now that we've confirmed that Kim's not
anyone,
a lice, I have
seen the Fifty Shades of Grey trailer.
Hey, we already had squirrel.
Oh, squirrel.
We had squirrel twice because we went from Kimmy Knits to lice.
Lice and
lice
50
oh,
Shades
you,
of Grey.
You should have scrolled out 50 Shades.
Did you see it?
Squirrel!
The trailer?
No. I haven't seen it either, but I heard that it's not going to be anything.
The squirrel has like 2 shades of grey.
It does.
It does.
He's working on it. Give him, cut him some slack.
Squirrel! This episode brought to you by Squirrel.
That's right. Sponsored by Squirrel.
Can you make a squirrel for us?
This like week's guest host.
Like a little
squirrel. Squirrel.
Player.
Yeah.
Probably could.
I'd like to come. Probably could.
Probably. Mm-hmm. Do you want? Would you like it holding a kraken? Or
I didn't say
a
it like that.
I have a kraken already.
Mm-hmm. I know.
I got the one you wanted.
Yes, you did. I'm going to try not to be bitter about that.
Right.
So
well, this lady bought a pair of earrings for me today that I wanted.
Was it me?
Trying not to be bitter about it.
Was it me? Because I know you wanted these.
No, it was the ones that matched. It was the ones I showed you. And then some lady came
out. The ones that were on top.
I have a crick in my neck and I can't look that direction.
She's old.
I was very upsetting.
Oh, look at you.
I'm old.
Oh,
that's so sweet.
I wasn't planning on staying very long.
That's okay, but now that you have a chair,
you
should.
Thank you, Erin.
Thanks, Erin. From Tempe Yarn and Fiber and science.
And beauty.
And beauty. And tech support.
And tech support.
And travel.
And chivalry.
And chivalry.
Yes.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, my gosh.
I can't keep track.
And local artists.
No wonder there's nothing in here.
It's too much.
Squirrel.
There's plenty in there, but it's all shiny. It's glitter, remember?
Glitter.
Glitter. Full of glitter. Oh my God. This is going to go long today. And you know what? We're filming really late in the day. So.
That's why I look a little haggard.
Yeah, a little bit of haggard.
A little frizzy. Because there's a little moist out there.
I should have a gel across the
I think
lens.
We should have solar
should
flares.
Have a gel.
Like in the new Star Wars trailer.
It looks solar pretty flare. Just like this. You can put it in
Star
the
Wars Ooh. Trailer. Oh, it's so pretty.
That's
oh my God.
That you got.
Here, stash and hands.
It
can't
is,
turn
it's,
your head.
It's the
I
one.
Can't. I can't turn my head. This is terrible. I have to turn my whole body. I'm like a robot. This is so sad. So, look at the new yarn that Kathy just got.
This is her stash enhancement.
This is stash enhancement.
I got, this is my fourth skate of yarn
Does
I got
remind
today.
Yeah, sorry. This is a preemptive Hoarder's Corner.
Hoarder's Corner for Kathy Canuel.
This is the fourth one I got today, so.
Fourth?
Oh, yeah.
Is it the fourth one of those?
The rest of my yarn tower is out in the car.
Oh.
Is it all
no,
that?
I bought one Dialicious from Nancy. I bought one of the Sonoran Desert Fiber
Did
yarn
you get some
beanies.
Gherkins?
And then, no, I didn't get any Christmas today. But I also got a lovely skein of yarn from Nick Nacaroni.
Thank you, Dan. Nick Nacaroni.
Did you set the timer? You did it.
I did.
Okay.
Want to share?
Oh, no, thank you. It's okay. I did the aw.
That was fabulous. That doesn't matter. It's all about the aw.
I took a drink earlier, so.
So that
she had to aw now.
It counts.
It was delayed. So, what time? It is.
I don't know how much time do we have.
We have time for this.
We'll have time for this. Okay, so, hey.
Hey.
Jeffrey. Hey. Steven.
Okay,
Positive Bakery Bears. So, it's time for Rainbow Shoutouts.
Do you want to join us?
This week? Oh my God, this is so much fun. So, we say hi to all of our Out and Proud gay subscribers and followers and friends. And yeah, we've got some new additions this week. I put the call out, well, when I say I mean we, put the call out last week or the week before that we needed more women because they were not representing. Well, guess what? Two more women! So we now have three! Three women on the shout out!
I'm excited. So let's do a rainbow shout out.
Okay, let's do it. So you want to start?
You start.
Okay, I'll start.
Then you go in this circle.
Navi Sama.
Ron Strong.
Lucas. Ross, Funko Boy. Yeah.
Casey Andrew.
Kenneth and Randall or
Kendall. Okay. Dennis and Rudy.
You skipped her.
Oh.
Oh, Dennis and Rudy, hi! We miss you today.
I do miss them. You. James, Dancing Geek. Hey, hey.
And Jonathan.
Well, they can be duty.
Sorry. That's what I said last week. That's exactly what I said last week.
Well, I totally didn't watch.
See, I like Rennis.
Okay,
okay, so Jonathan.
Hi, Jonathan.
I meant to.
Okay. Oh, it's her.
David and Michael.
You know them.
You know David and Michael.
They come here.
I'm sure.
Yeah.
I will. I was seeing, sorry.
They gave us yarn.
I just put her on the spot and I'm going to get beat up for it.
It's going to happen later.
Hey, Sean Nittycub.
Did you see his picture today?
I did not.
He was out and about and bored, so he posted a cheeky picture of himself. I know.
Cheeky, cheeky.
It was, and it was really cute. Really cheeky. I love his cheeky pictures. Christopher Knits with Balls.
Drew. Mission Knit Possible.
Score. Jake of Snake Knits.
And Michael, who's Pogo Mike.
And Barry, who is Barry Knits.
And Cameron Jolie, who's Cammy Lammy.
Yay! And then.
That's our first woman.
Guess what? Here's the two new additions. Okay, Jenny Lynn Knits. Welcome.
Welcome.
Welcome, your first week on Rainbow Shout Out.
Or Maja.
I think, okay, this was the problem.
She's Swedish.
She's Swedish, and I think it's Maja.
And it's S-J-O-M-A-J-L-I-N.
Yeah.
Smalja-bilden.
And I can't say it.
Can I say it one more time? Yes. S-J-O-M-A-J-L-I-N.
That's right. And our American mouths cannot make that Swedish
I can't
sound.
Even speak English. I can't.
I tried listening to you introduce yourself on your podcast a couple times in a row just so that I could catch how to say your name, and I thought I heard Maja, but I was really tired. So if that's wrong, message me and tell me how to pronounce your name because I'm so excited.
Your podcast is wonderful. I will link you to it.
Okay. Maja or S.J.
Schmalgen.
Oh, Schmalgen. No, it's not Schmalgen, I know. I know it's not Schmalgen. I'm going to call you Maja. You're beautiful.
She is.
She's really pretty.
I played her, she told me which episode she talked about us, and I played it for my husband, because she was saying how she had one of her guy friends over. She played a little bit of this, of us, and he watched the whole episode and was laughing the whole time, and another episode started playing, and she goes, do you still want to watch this? And he's like, yeah, I think I want to.
We're kind of addicting in a really kind of weird way.
Yeah.
All right.
Well, we're gonna pause and you're gonna go because she's exhausted.
Disappear.
She's had a very hard day of sell.
Wait, it's a magic trick.
I love it. Awesome.
I think I moved.
I think I did too. And she's gone.
Oh, wow.
She disappeared.
And where'd I remember.
Bye, Kathy.
Bye.
So. That was super fun to have her there.
We have had a day.
It's
so
been a great day. Long, warm.
Yeah.
Dark.
Yeah. Very much so.
Okay, so
very much so.
We did rainbows.
We did rainbows.
So should we do doctory?
Let's do our
do showgirls.
Yeah, showgirls first.
Okay.
Showgirls first, and then it's alive. Sexy showgirls. Sexy showgirls. Sexy showgirls. Vogue.
episode.
I do what I was told.
I am punch drunk.
She had too much Mexican.
I am punch
too much good
drunk.
Mexican food. I love what Navi said.
Navi, and you know who you are.
Yes, that's La Rosa did open a restaurant, and it was good. Yes, it was. Okay, so.
I only have one item that I'm showing off that I'm working on.
Only one?
Okay. Because technically, I only worked on one thing and that's done. Okay. And I only picked this up yesterday again, so.
That's all right. You
I'm working on the Jay Walker sock in the Desert Vista Color Dyeway, whatever that store, wonderful place, woman is.
Desert Vista Dyeworks, Susan Hayes.
Words. In the colorway, you're a mean one.
In an homage to me.
Yes.
That's right.
So this still the first one. I'm loving the Jaywalker. It's a free pattern on Ravelry. And I think it's knitting up wonderful. I love the stripes and how they're jagging.
I think I'm going to have to copy you.
I think that this is the perfect colorway
for
that pattern.
Yeah, and I have made the Jaywalkers many, many times. I also made a pattern from a long, long time ago called Broad Ripple, if anybody remembers that sock pattern that was all the rage for a while.
Wow.
And it's very similar.
Is it like Feather and Vanish?
No. It's similar to this, only I think it had a few more
jags.
But it was a fun one, too. But I really like the way that's...
I think it's adorable.
I think I might have to do that.
I will let you, and I will not get upset.
Well, that's because you don't get upset about that. Only I do.
Well, you get upset.
That's right.
About
because yeah, that's true. I'm kind of
like
cranky.
You got upset at the McDonald's girl.
She deserved it. They went through. I am not kidding you. 9 cups trying to get a cup of water in a styrofoam cup order right. 9 cups.
We ordered a Diet Coke, a Coke, and a cup of water
in a styrofoam,
cup.
Because she likes it to stay cold.
I like my water cold.
She's a fragile flower. She needs that cold water. I'm just
Somebody needs to cool this off.
That's right. Hot. Mm-hmm. So anyways.
Yeah. That's all I have to show is my Jaywalkers.
Oh, really?
Well, guess what?
It's
fun in it, too.
I have so much to show.
Good.
I do. It's going to go really long. Look.
Is that all you have to knit on, too?
Toe beanie. That's what I got, baby. That's all I got.
Because she really was busy this week.
Oh, I'll tell you about my week with We Have Time for a How Was Your Week segment, and you will hear about it. But I finished the first sock, and I'm making ankle socks because, as everyone knows, I've already done like 4. I did three knee highs, and I found one that I loaned to Debbie, so now I have 4 pairs of knee-high striped socks.
And so this is when she's on the couch.
These are in the family room.
You should knit like 4 of the same sock of that color.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. I could probably knit 6 or 8 of the same sock.
That's true. Well, on your foot size,
telling you. I'm also thinking I might knit Amy some socks.
She needs them. Oh, that picture made me so sad.
I know. She wasn't as sad as she looked, and as soon as she got down off the bed... If anyone follows me on Instagram, which I think a few of you might, I took a picture of my dog last night because I had put socks, my little kid, ankle socks on her feet because she is obsessively licking and chewing at her feet. And she's always licked her feet, and we know she has contact allergies with the grass, but she is, I think it's now become an obsessive compulsive behavior. And I think it's probably more out of boredom than anything else. So when she's not sleeping or playing outside, she's licking and chewing on those feet. And the only problem is that she's hurting herself now.
Right.
So she'll do that for a while.
Get real hot spots.
And then she'll stand up and she can't put weight on that foot. And it's a mess. Poor little thing. But I put socks on her feet. And when her dad goes downstairs after I go to bed with her at night, when my husband goes downstairs at 11 for his, muffin or ice cream or whatever treat he needs, she goes down with him.
Right.
Because, of course, he gives her cookies. And I said, oh, my God.
Cookies or carrots?
Cookies. No, I'm the one that gives her healthy treats and healthy food. Just saying. And she goes down, and she had the socks on her feet. And I was like, oh, my God, is she going to go for it? Is she going to do it? And she jumped down off the bed, but when she landed on the floor, she knew she had socks on. So she kind of did the one paw up thing. But it wasn't too bad, and she made it to the top of the stairs. Funny, but she stopped at the top of the stairs.
She was
scared. Like, so I got up and took the socks off her feet. But
good moment.
Poor little thing.
So is that everything for show?
That is everything I have for Showgirls. I really sorry, you guys. There was absolutely zero knitting this week. Zero.
I knit. I was busy this week, but I did knit.
Yeah.
But it was only on one thing, really.
I had zero and, zero. Zero knitting.
I'll take that from you.
Thank you. I'm still hot.
You're wearing your cowl.
Okay, so I've been watching a few podcasts starting last night. It was the first time I had a chance to do it. But I've been noticing for the past few weeks, people, you know, because you live in cold places.
Get so to wear their knitted stuff.
But everybody's podcast, they're wearing their cute knit hats and their scarves and their cowls and their mitts. Mm-hmm. And it's so damn hot. We're freezing here today because it was all of 74. 74, 75.
And humid, though. It was humid.
Yeah.
Like my hair, it's frizzy.
Yeah. It's been for the past few days, and it would have been nice.
My hair has not been frizzy for the past
few days. No, it's been humid for the past few days. But I thought maybe I wouldn't have a heat stroke if I just wore cowls. So this is hand spun by me. I don't remember who the dyer was. I'm really sorry. It may have been. Yes, I do. All spun up.
Oh.
Kirsten. All spun up. And I loved the yarn, and so I made a cowl, and I love it, and it makes me happy.
Beautiful.
So there.
Maybe if you walk Amy in the morning, you'll be cold enough.
Yeah, that's going to happen today.
No.
Anywho, that's all I was doing.
Hey, so I think we have time to start. Well, yeah, we can start.
Yeah, we can start. Cool. Our handy dandy.
I only have one thing.
Yeah. I
can't hear you.
Two. Can you hear me now? I wouldn't yell and I made sure. I am not a sadist. I don't care what you've heard.
I'm alive.
That's right. Thank you.
Thank you.
It's alive. No. Let me see.
Glitter.
I hear glitter. It's like a glitter shaker.
Yeah.
That's what it sounds like in there.
Yeah.
That's pretty awesome. So, you go first. What
all right,
have?
I have one thing.
Okay, cool.
And with this thing, I ended up playing yarn chicken with it. But I made a little noodle.
I just love that little dog. Oh my
the
god, pla- it's so
the
cute.
Pattern is by Susan Claudino.
I love it.
It's knit out of Rowan's Cash Soft, and I only had one skein of this golden color.
Yeah.
And I played yarn chicken, but I ended up having to add a design element.
And I love it. I swear, I didn't realize you played yarn chicken. I thought you did it on purpose, because that almost looks Feral.
It is.
Feral. It's so cute.
It is. It's my version of Feral and Tarja, do what I can to make it work.
Yeah. I think it's perfect.
So anywho, he doesn't have a first name yet, though.
That's okay. We'll find him one, right?
Yeah. I don't know. If you have any ideas.
Yes, interwebs. Name your noodle.
So that's, I love him, though. And I had to embroider the little nosy because I didn't have any of the nose beads.
I think I just have one nose left.
What were we using those on? Did we use them on hedgehogs?
Yeah, that's why we got them.
We made a bunch of hedgehogs once.
Oh, Lord, did we make a bunch of
I made more than you did.
Yeah,
I made like seven.
You always make more than me.
That's not true.
Hat. Unless it's a hat. Okay.
Let's show off yours.
I'm going to show this off, and Kay, I've got fuzz. I had fuzz on my lip.
We better sip it out.
We better. Okay, we'll pose and we'll do this in a second.
Yeah.
Well, BRB. And we're back. Don't forget the time. Thank you. Like I would forget the camera. You wouldn't. Well, you have forgotten the time. Okay, so, as I was saying, okay, I'm really sorry.
Came from
baby. But I am going to show this off anyway, even though she doesn't have her little sweater.
She's
but
naked!
I finished this last week, and I didn't bring it because I didn't have the sweater, but I felt like, you know what? This was not the week to get the sweater done, but I will get it done. But I wanted to show you guys, oh my god, how
it's
cute!
The,
it's a little gelato
giraffe!
Kay, you did an amazing job on this pattern again. So cute. I used the Malabrigo Rios in the Primavera colorway and then the natural colorway. So they're both Malabrigo Rios. So this little giraffe is so soft.
It's the Miss Gelato Giraffe by Kay F. Jones of the Bakery Bears podcast.
Yep.
I was thinking last night, because I know she's been designing some more toys and stuff in her head. And I just want to put it out there to challenge you wonderful toy designers. I know there's several frog patterns out there, but I would like a frog to go
with the bakery bear and the gelato giraffe, or even Susan, if you wanted to do one, Claudino.
She's a frog.
I'd like a frog pattern for knit.
She's a frog freak. Well, I'm thinking.
But isn't that cute?
It's so cute, and I think I might do a peach color sweater. And I got little pale blue buttons today, so we'll see if those work. But I could just not be more thrilled. Such an easy pattern to do.
So cute.
Great detail.
So cute.
Every step explained beautifully. Again, just like with the bakery bears. So, love it. Here she is.
Super fun.
Very excited.
Well written. Very good.
Okay. Next.
You got another one, baby.
I got another one. I finished my cool hoss, as you know, and I forgot it last time.
Can they
time.
See the colors?
I don't know.
Here, let's show it. It's so rich.
It's the Malabrigo Rios and the colorway Vaa, V-A-A, and they were all capital on the color thing. I made it for my son, and unfortunately, I think it's a little bit big, and he's not. Yeah, it's kind of longer than the other two that
you know
I made
it
him
for.
Because it's a thicker yarn, and so it he doesn't like hats that go way over his ears. It's Arizona; he'll die of a heat stroke. So he hasn't figured out how to wear this yet. So he may or may not be keeping it. So we'll see.
I'm sure someone will love it.
I love it. I think someone would.
It's beautiful. I love that. Well, I haven't really worked on my hat this week. That's why it's not in my project. So.
Okay. The last thing that I brought.
What?
I know. The last thing I brought.
This one deserves a dance.
Yeah. This is kind of embarrassing, actually, because I've washed these
several times.
Several times, and the yarn is growing. As it's washed.
It's not
so
her.
Please don't think that, and there's nothing wrong with it. Big shorts are fine. Big shorts are great.
It's all about
but
that.
I'm just saying that if there wasn't a waist drawstring band on these, they would not stay up on me anymore.
They're so
but,
cute though.
Barry, I hope you're watching because you instigated this knit along. We saw the pattern one night, started a knit along that night, and finished them in like I think a week.
Yes, you did.
But as soon as I finished them, I put them on and I didn't take them off for 2 weeks. So here are my Stephen West shorts. They're sport shorts. Are
they're
they
so
not
cute?
Cute?
Look at that tushy.
I know. He has little, darts.
Darts. Short rows.
To add.
God, that's soft. I'm going to rub
extra,
my butt.
Yeah.
Oh,
it has some
so
extra
soft.
Fabric in the buttockle region. So that if you have a sweet little bubble butt, like Stephen West does, you got some room in your sport shorts. I myself, being a 48-year-old white woman, ain't got no junk in the trunk. There's not a whole lot going on. So it's fine to have a few darts, but unnecessary for me.
Well, you can always throw in one of those, what do they call them? The
if I
butt
ever,
bras?
I don't know, something.
Butt bra.
I gotta cut out some soap.
Pantyhose.
Padding like Raven.
you
and
Juju
B. I gotta pad that ass.
Pad that ass.
But anyway, so my shorts are done. This is in Rowan Cash
Soft. It's really
soft.
It's sad that I wanna put my face where your butt goes.
I know, and I'm really sorry, but yeah, they are kind of soft. They really are, and I will probably wear them tonight. So there. So there are the shorts.
Those are awesome.
That's all I have.
Those are awesome. That
they
was,
are
that
pretty
was
awesome.
Amazing.
That was pretty fun. And they were really fun to knit, and they went a lot faster than I thought. Right, Barry? He started another pair not long after.
Oh.
I haven't seen him finished yet.
Hmm. How many skeins did you use?
One of the kind of sagey green, and then I think I used either two or three of the orange. I can't remember.
That's the same yarn that I made mine out of.
How is that so tight when
my
gauge is so
really,
loose?
Really, really small needle.
Huh.
I used a really small needle.
Hmm. I guess. I was going to say all we got is a truck driving
Arizona
into the building.
Wow.
Yeah. So.
Was it Sue and my friend Befuddled mentioned how fun it was to be spoken of during podcasts. You can send messages to us anytime you like. We're on there on Ravelry.
We are.
We listen. We talk.
Speaking of Ravelry, I just want to point this out, even though it's out of context. Squirrel! We will be drawing for the winner of the Desert Vista Dyeworks knit-along today at the end of the podcast. I will also post the winner over on the Ravelry thread, but it ended on at midnight on November 30th.
So the thread's
and long. We had, I think, like 27, I think.
Mm-hmm.
I think it was 27 entries. And we, through random number generator, will be drawing and announcing the winner
of the skein of Witchy Woman,
Witchy
with Desert Vista Dyeworks.
Witchy, witchy woman.
Very exciting.
Yeah, it is.
Very exciting. So all we have left is Hoarder's Corner for
and just talking.
Stash enhancement. And how long do we have? Because I thought we could start next.
Did you see in the last episode when we looked to see how everybody, it was Laura and Liz and you and I, well, went like this to look at my clock?
Uh-huh.
It was adorable.
We're cute. We're pretty cute.
I thought we were pretty. Hey,
oh my God, hi Liz! Travel correspondent Liz! Say hi.
Hi.
She was being the tourist with her brother in town today, so she is definitely the travel correspondent.
Arizona tour guide, a.k.a. travel correspondent.
And tech support.
And tech support. Yeah, that's right. Saved the day, didn't she?
Yeah.
So, yeah, we're still stalling. Let's just go ahead and start Hoarder's Corner, because I don't have that much, and we might as well just give it a go.
All right.
So, Hoarder's Corner. Original artwork by Deb Weir.
You go first.
Okay, I think I have one.
I thought you had two.
What was my other one?
I guess I have two. I'll go first.
She has two.
Wait, we can go together on this one.
We can go together. There is a special someone out there, and she knows who she is. Nick Macaroni. Nick Macaroni. We have decided that we are now in a present war.
We are in a present war. Present war!
Present war! Because you keep, oh, you're too good to us.
Very good.
Too good to us.
And perfect choices.
And perfect choices. We just received the most beautiful package from her. And that is my stash enhancement for this week because I didn't buy
any. You bought earrings.
I did. I bought the beautiful.
And cookies for your doggy.
And doggy treats, but those aren't really stash enhancements. So, you want to go? One, two, three. Look at the beauty that
is. Look at this gorgeousness.
Malabrigo sock.
In the perfect color
ways. In the perfect color ways for each of us.
It is. Mm-hmm. It's a Christmas miracle.
It's beautiful. And look at Christmassy colors.
That's
right
what
there.
I just that made me think of that.
If we had jingle bells, I would jingle them.
Jingle bells. Jingle, 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 jingle.
We need jingle bells.
I think we should.
I have a jingle bell stick, and when I'm putting up my tree this weekend, if I can find it, I will bring it.
That sounds like a great
plan. A jingle bell
I wish stick. I had my idea hat for you. This is the colorway Ivy.
Things.
Oh, by the way, it's Malabrigo. And it's Ivy. New. What did you get?
Tiziano Red.
Tiziano Red.
Or Tiziano Red, maybe? Tiziano
she
Red.
Would know.
Yeah,
honey,
she would.
Tell us.
She did tell me I said the name of that colorway right.
I know.
I was very excited about that.
Mm-hmm. I know.
Right.
I know.
Okay, so what's your next one?
Oh, I have one more.
You have
but
one more.
Wait. I have one more, and I'll come back with it.
And we're back!
Start. So we're continuing on.
In Hoarder's Corner.
In Hoarder's Corner.
Original artwork by Deb Weir.
And
that sky is looking
it's
crazy
creepy.
Back
it's
there.
Creepy.
Yeah, it is.
I had never heard of this dyer, actually.
No?
And it was the content, the fiber content that made me get it, because we went on a little field trip after lunch today.
We did.
And
we were
it
in
was
the
name that made me want it. But look, it's going to pill a little because there's cashmere in it.
Yeah.
But it's still okay.
It's going to be worth it.
This is called Marianne Nated Yarns.
Hmm.
She's an indie dyer out in New Jersey, and they were having a trunk fair, or trunk show. And it's 80% superwash merino, 10% cashmere, 10% nylon, approximately 600 yards, in the colorway Grage.
It's a perfect name for that colorway, too.
Grage. So, I think this is definitely going up here around my face.
I don't know what it's going to be yet, you know what it would be beautiful as?
What?
And I'm saying this totally sincerely, and I think that you could knit it. If you felt like it, I think you could totally do it. Because I don't. The Pretty Little Thing pattern by the Yarn Harlot.
What?
And it's a cowl, and it's a lace.
I'm
and it's
huge
absolutely beautiful. But if you wanted it by your face.
I'd rather have like a scarf.
A scarf?
Shawl scarf. Because I like to be able to take things off simply.
Would it work for that beautiful scarf pattern you made for me in that gorgeous red?
Isn't it cool enough for you to wear that yet?
Yeah, I was going to wear it today, but I thought I'd better wear something
smaller. Because it's actually quite cooling.
It is, and it's Christmassy, so I was thinking about saving it for like a Christmas episode. I don't know.
I'll have things on my head.
You'll have things on your head, and I will have something around my neck.
That's right.
Could be her hands. I don't
so
know.
So that was the last of my stash enhancement, and it was just a surprise that I actually did that. Because I really wasn't going to be buying anything.
She wasn't, but you know what? She deserves it. And
I've never bought my own cashmere.
You hardly ever stash enhance. I'm buying stuff all the time, and you always like are so good about it. No, I don't need any more.
I'm not.
And you needed that. Yes, you are.
I just like the unusual color.
I think it's absolutely stunning.
Look at my nails with that unusual color.
You know,
squirrel. Color. You're looking mighty fine today, my lady.
I think it's beautiful. Why, thank you.
You're welcome.
So are you. So is that all we have, all of our segments?
Yeah, I'm thirsty though. It's kind of warm. Did you see that my Zeta Bipper pole fell off my Bakery Bears bag and I finally found it?
Oh, well, so you'll have to reattach it.
I will. I'll have Kathy do it for me.
Oh, that'd be a good idea.
It's very pretty.
Glad you found it.
I am too. I was very upset when I saw that.
Get your drink.
Yes, ma'am. So it was hecko busy in here today.
It was.
Hecko busy.
Totally. I had to park so far away when I got here because this parking lot, it's, I mean, sometimes it's kind of busy, but oh my God, I've never seen it like this.
I'm happy they had a great day. They had a great day.
It was fantastic. Wall-to-wall vendors, wall-to-wall customers. Mm-hmm. I hope they had a great day. It seemed like they did. Wonderful trunk show. It was kind of a trunk show. It's a local artist. It's a celebration of local artists. And Kathy participates every year.
Mm-hmm.
I used to when I had time to hand
spin. You're so busy.
And I don't anymore. So maybe someday. I don't know. We'll see.
That was a door.
That was a door. You know what's really great is the absence of the door.
Beep, 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 beep.
Every time
beep, beep, beep.
Out the door. I bet Barry's dogs appreciate this episode.
Yeah.
A lot more than they appreciate last week. Just saying.
We really enjoyed Dan and Kay's latest episode. Of the Bakery Bears podcast, I watched.
And not for nothing, when she showed that little mouse head, Kay,
oh my God.
I was sitting there watching that last night with my husband was in the room, and when you said that, I said, I just can't. They told me to look away, look away. And she said, you just said it's too cute.
So look away.
And I looked at my husband, I said, it's true, I did. I said that. I said, it's too cute. I just can't. I literally can't.
Just can't.
Can't. Oh my God, I can only turn that way.
Well,
that still hurt
that
too.
Hurt real bad.
It hurt real bad. I got a crick because I slept wrong. I got a crick in my neck.
It's because she's evil.
I am. It's true.
But it was great. And then Bryony looked so cute in that hat again. Oh,
she did. I
love
the, the travel through York was really fun. Mm-hmm. I agree with you, Kay, that Bryony and Dan, evil, pure evil. But you expect that from Gingers. You do. And the
even
fact
though his hair is going back in
dark brown.
Said.
Yeah, well, there's still Ginger in his heart.
It's Ginger in his heart.
And they kept that knit shop from her.
I know.
Holy mackerel. Mm.
I wouldn't forgive him either, Kate.
No.
Watched Nick Nagaroni this week.
Did you? I haven't seen her. I mean, I've seen her on Instagram and we chatted, but I didn't see a new...
Well, she's working a lot.
Yeah. Okay.
I think I watched one of Helen's. I watched a little bit of James.
I did watch Helen, but not her most recent one. She did another one, and I thought, oh my God, another one already. That was great. But I watched the other one.
Is it Denise of Knit and Den?
Yes.
And I watched Maja. I think that's
I did too. She's so pretty. God, she's...
I like listening to her. She's so smart.
I love her voice, and I love that accent. I'm just a... God, I'm a sucker for an accent, but she's just got one of those truly beautiful faces.
Classic.
Her bone structure.
Oh, God. You look gorgeous without makeup, but I would love to paint your face. With that bone structure, oh, my God.
Yeah, she would beat you to filth.
Well, I like to paint people, so
yeah.
I love to paint anybody, but oh my God.
Be you too, Phil. And she's just, God, you're so pretty, Maja. You're just so pretty.
That mitten she made with the power on it.
I know. She's cute. So cute. I like her stuff a lot.
Mm-hmm.
What else was going on this week? I wish I could remember. I know I went over to the Ravelry board. Sue has been back.
Yeah, and then
which is wonderful.
The username Lester. The last comment I read yesterday, I think, was Lester mentioned that we made her day because she doesn't have a yarn store near her. It's miles away. And I was like, we're your yarn store.
We're your yarn, your knit group. I remember, and I still go back and watch it because I am a geek like that. I will go back and watch the very first episode of our show. And when I was talking about when I used to watch the... VHS because they were the VHS tapes of Meg and Elizabeth Zimmerman
because you didn't have
didn't have a knit group, and it felt so good just to sit there and listen to people talking about knitting, and it was
yarn,
so,
fiber, crochet. Yeah. I've been crocheting again this week, so
oh my God, I saw it, granny squares. Oh my God, see, you had other stuff in progress.
Yeah, but I don't want to show that one.
Why?
It might be a surprise.
Oh well, whatever. Whatever, I know there's all kinds of surprise, like Christmas knitting, so I can't talk about anybody's projects because I might accidentally give something away because I'm really terrible like that. So how much time do we have left?
Eons.
Eons? How much is eons?
1 minute, 50 seconds.
That's not eons. We're going to have to go into another
Tell your
segment.
Story about your week. Are we going to?
Well, because we've got to do the drawing.
Oh, yeah.
My week is
not
just,
important enough?
Well,
we don't have to do a full segment. That way we don't have to go over your time limit.
It's terrible. Well, I don't have a huge time limit, but we can do a segment for the... Well,
yeah,
we'll do a segment for pulling the winner.
Winner, chicken dinner.
Winner. So this, I'm really sorry that I was not around this week, but I had...
She'll have vacation soon.
House drama.
You had house drama?
I
How
had
come you don't tell
major
me these things?
House drama. Because here's the deal. I am reaching a point now where I honestly think I have anxiety issues.
Wait a second.
You're going to smack me.
Look at the sky. It's painted.
I know. It is.
A squirrel.
It's because it's pink and blue. It's because hell just froze over and there's fire in the sky. Yes. Yes. That's not a sense.
I can take a picture and show you.
Hellfire. I had such a terrible time this week. I wanted to switch home warranty companies because I have not, anybody who's known me at all knows that I have like the worst home warranty coverage in the world. And I went one summer for almost nine weeks with no air conditioning because they were so awful. And I'm paranoid about my air conditioning anyway. And so I have noticed, I mean, I've had a lot of stress and a lot of anxiety, but you know, I always figure that's just normal. It's life. I'm not anxious or having terrible anxiety attacks over things that I think are abnormal. I feel like the things that I have an anxiety attack over are perfectly normal and reasonable to be anxious about. So I'm starting to think that may not be the case. Pose.
And we're back.
Why is it not the case?
Because I think that the... You know, all my life, if I've had, you know, I've been nervous about something, my brain will just latch on and obsess about it.
Yes, it
but
does. Yes, it does.
I am obsessive.
Obsess about
I
things.
Am obsessive. But it's never been to a point where if I can logically say to myself, look, calm down, there's nothing you can do about it now, just stop worrying about it, it'll turn out fine, or the person's coming to fix it tomorrow, whatever, and that would calm me down and I would be fine, because my logic would tell me, that's stupid for you to be so freaked out about this. I can't do that anymore. So even when I logically tell my brain, stop, I can't. So I was a bundle of anxiety this week. So starting Monday, I called a new home warranty company, bought a new warranty with them. They needed to come out and do an inspection of the house. So I scheduled it immediately. They were gonna come out on Wednesday. Tuesday night, I'm sitting on my couch, and every time my air conditioner kicks on, and yes, people, it's December and my air is still
on. I still have mine on.
Every time my AC unit kicks on, the units are right behind the wall that I sit against, so I hear it, and my body physically reacts every single time with just a relief. I can feel the cortisol. I can feel that stress hormone.
The relief that it's going to work.
No. The anxiety that is it going to stay on? Did it kick on? Did it just kick off? Is something wrong? Oh, terrible. So Tuesday night,
therapy.
I heard, no, I need something or meds, I don't know. But I heard it kick on Tuesday night, and it kicked on, and then kicked off. And then it kicked on again, and I was just at that point where I had the sweats, I thought I was going to throw up, and then it stayed on. And I thought, okay, but there's something wrong with this unit. I knew it. And so Wednesday morning, of course, they come, they inspect. They find everything I knew they were going to find, which was nothing major. I have a sink in my kitchen. The faucet leaks a little. They found that. My microwave has been broken, which is fine. And then my dishwasher I never use. So they couldn't test it because if they turn on a dishwasher that hasn't been used in 12 years, the seals are rotted. They'll flood my kitchen.
Right.
So he also found my air conditioning wasn't working.
Oh, my God.
So my
I feel like
week,
crying for you.
I know. So my whole week was... Oh, let's see. It was like WebMD of home warranties. You know how if you like, I've got a sniffle or my finger hurts a little bit, I go to WebMD, it's cancer. It's cancer. I know. So the interwebs, I know. I went on the interwebs and I'm looking up this new home warranty company. 20 million complaints with the Better Business Bureau about exactly the case scenario of they had we had an air conditioner that didn't work, and they said that it had this issue, which was a low split differential. Trust me, HVAC people, you know what I'm talking about. They gave the same diagnosis. They would have it fixed. The next time it would break down, the home warranty company would deny it and say that's a pre-existing condition. Because we knew that it wasn't working before, but we fixed it. But no, you didn't really, because if you'd fixed it, then this wouldn't have happened. And we can already tell that the unit was in bad shape before we went into the warranty, so we're not going to pay for it. I freaked out. So I had to call my existing warranty, who I hate, despised, had to call them to come fix the sink, fix the microwave, fix the air conditioner. So I was going to have three companies come to my house that I didn't know. I didn't trust anybody they were going to send. I have been...
Oh my gosh. Okay. No, what do you have a kink in your neck?
Yeah. So I have a really rock hard kink in my neck. And guess what? As it turns out. So everybody will know that I'm okay. It turns out my old warranty company that I hate like crazy has gone through some sort of customer service change.
Oh, wonderful.
So, and so has the air conditioning contractor that they sent to fix my AC, who... Two summers ago when they came out, I would have shot if they had tried to come back into my house because they were that terrible. They are now fantastic.
Great.
Super amazing. He came out, he fixed my air conditioner yesterday. It was fabulous. The sink guy came out, but he couldn't fix it because I don't have faucet coverage. So I paid this guy $65 to come to my house to tell me, you don't have coverage for faucets, but my old warranty, who I hated, called me immediately before the guy had even left my house to explain to me why it wasn't covered, and then to say we will refund that $65.
I know. I think it's time to draw a name.
I think it is too.
That's a great story.
So much better.
Oh, good.
Okay, so that was my week. So now we are going to draw the winner. Wait a second. While you're doing that, all we need is a random number generator. And I've got to see, because I don't remember if I kept it in my thing. I did!
Okay, we were just dancing.
Sorry, I had to search it out. The winner of the Desert Vista Dyeworks Knit Along is going to receive this beautiful skein of Desert Vista Dyeworks Viso self-striping sock yarn in the Witchy Woman colorway.
Witchy Woman.
So we had...
How many?
27. Hang on. We had 27 entries into that thread. The picture's only thread. The first one doesn't count because that's me.
Mm-hmm. Oh, so there's 26?
So it should be... 26. And then let me see. No, wait, I take that back. We are going to have to add because I had more. We had 28.
Okay, I got it.
Okay, so random number generator will pick a number and then whoever's post that is.
Ready?
Will win.
13.
Let's see who it was. Let's see who number 13 is. Sorry, people. I'm scrolling through my mobile site.
Is it Sue?
Oh my gosh. Sue. It's Family Diva.
It's Family Diva.
And there's on my phone. There's
Look
the
at
socks that.
That
she knit. Oh my God, Sue.
That is so cool.
I am so excited. Are you excited?
That's so awesome.
I am so excited for you. She thinks she never wins anything. Sue, Family Diva, if you would get in touch with me on Ravelry, just send me a Ravelry message with your address, current address, because I know you moved, and let me know where we can send this to you, and I will send you off this lovely skein of Witchy Woman. Wonderful.
That's a Christmas joyful thing.
It is a Christmas joyful thing, and I'm trying to see, and I think that my thing is flashing red. So,
okay.
It is time to say goodbye.
All right.
It was wonderful. Thank you guys for stopping by.
I'm so glad you got to vent.
I'm so glad I got to vent. And I will see you guys next week.
Yeah, bye.
Bye.